Guys, I've got some bad news for you today. This may come as a disappointment to some of you. You may notice that I'm missing my chain. I forgot it today. I'm sorry. I've let myself down. I've let you down. If you came just to see the gold chain, stop watching now. I'm sorry.
Young Mark Watney, study astrobotany. I make hanging gardens and nobody can stop me. Let's grow plants in space.
Welcome to the Astrobotany Show. I'm your host, Kai Rasmussen, and this week we'll be starting where we left off. How do plants know what direction to grow, and how do they know what direction to grow in outer space? If we're going to start talking about plant gravitropism, or how a plant responds to gravity, we'll have to talk about some of the science behind it. I'm sorry, guys, there's just no avoiding it, because that's where all the action happens. The good place to start is in the roots. All right, there we go. This poor plant that I just ripped out of the soil is Mizuna. It's a type of East Asian lettuce, and it is in the Brassica family. It's also a NASA target crop, which has been grown on the International Space Station. A NASA target crop is a plant variety that is good for sustenance. So Mizuna here has a lot of leafy biomass, and it would be a tasty treat for astronauts. This is Mizuna lettuce. And this is supposed to be a representation of a single plant cell, specifically in the roots. As you may know, the cell has many different compartments. You've probably heard of the phrase, the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. Well, there's another part of the cell that's called the amyloplast. I'd like to say that the amyloplasts are the gravity sensors of the cell. I won't get too much into this, but all you need to know is that when the plant cell turns, the amyloplasts are affected by gravity and they rotate in whatever direction that they go in, the plant grows. The plant roots actually reorient themselves to grow downwards.
Let's take a look at this video of auxin spreading through the root tip. You can see that it's accumulating at the bottom. Auxin is a plant growth hormone that drives growth in a plant.
So obviously the question is, how does this affect plant growth in space?
All right guys, it's time to checkity check this out. This is one of the first time-lapse videos of plants being grown in space. It's from Annalisa Paul and Rob Ferl at the University of Florida Space Plants Lab. On the left are the plants grown on Earth, and on the right are the ones grown in space. You can see that in the right petri dish, the root growth is erratic. And actually, the paper that was written about this asserts that in the absence of gravity, plants grow towards light. Here we have another video of Arabidopsis that was grown normally at first, but then later tilted at an angle. You can see how the influence of gravity affects the direction that it grows in.
The plant's response to gravity is just one of the many types of environmental stress responses that we have to consider as astrobotanists when we grow plants in space. This effect, more commonly described as gravitropism, is a critical part of astrobotany research. We have to know exactly how gravity affects the plants on a molecular level and how we can help the roots orient in a direction that is optimal for nutrient uptake. Let's eat plants in space.
Let's grow plants in space.
Hey guys, welcome to the Astrobotany Item of the Week, where we go over the Astrobotany Item of the Week. This week's item is the two-dimensional clinostat. A clinostat is a piece of scientific equipment that rotates a sample in a way that mimics microgravity or applies a gravitational stressor. You can see in the experiment that we're running, we have plants that are being stressed in such a way that their field of gravity is constantly changing. You can think of it as an amusement park for plants.
except they're not enjoying it. The reason why we call this a two-dimensional clinostat is because we also have three-dimensional clinostats, which rotate on two axes as opposed to one to achieve a more comprehensive effect. You're probably wondering, Kai, why don't you just send plants to space whenever you want to perform a gravity experiment? Well, let me tell you something. To send a plant to space, you need one of these things, a rocket. And to get one of these things, you need a little bit of this. And I'm no rocket scientist, but I bet that a rocket costs more than $10. And that's the reason why we use a clinostat to test plants under gravity stress. See you next week. Let's grow plants in space. I need to take a moment
just to stop and thank my. If you have any questions about astrobotany, feel free to let us know in the comments section below, or if you just want a more in-depth explanation.